And you see, for many of us, we would never have heard about Egypt or Ethiopia, proper names being Kemet and Cush. We'd never know anything about it if it hadn't been for what? The Bible. That was the first introduction that we had to it. The motion pictures that you saw, Carlton Heston and everybody in, opened the door to it. So therefore, the book can be, because there are some folk who go to another extreme. There are some folks that think the Bible is the answer to everything, and that's all you need. And there's other people that go to another extreme that say, well, we don't need it at all. Let's just throw it in the trash. Now, obviously, that's not the thing to do. Because Nat Turner found a way to use it, Harriet Tubman found a way to use it, and we have Dr. King found a way to use it, Brother Malcolm found a way to use it, Elijah Muhammad, we have found ways of using it, and we should use it because it's originally our book, and you don't take something that somebody has taken from you and messed up and throw it away. If somebody take your house away from you and rearrange it, you change it, when you get your house back, if it's a sturdy house, what you gonna do? You gonna throw the house away or burn it down, or what are you gonna do? You gonna put it back like it should be, because it was what? It was yours in the first place. So that's how it is when we're dealing with the Bible. Now, let's go into lesson one, the African origin of the Bible. And we're gonna be taking breaks along the way, and we're going to have time for question and answers. Are you ready? Let me make sure I'm ready. I don't need this microphone, do I? No, okay.
Because whilst our God has no color, and yet it is human to see everything through one's own spectacles, and since the white people have seen their God through their white spectacles, we have only now started to see our God through our own spectacles. But we believe in the God of Ethiopia, the everlasting God, God of Father, God of Son, God of Holy Ghost, the one God of all ages. That is the God in whom we believe, but we shall worship him through the spectacles of Ethiopia. For 250 years, we have struggled under the burden and rigors of slavery.
What has been written down in history. Up until the Nicene Conference of Bishops in 325, when Rome, under the order of Constantine, the Roman Emperor, ordered the 219th bishop at Nicaea, and they took away Christianity from the Africans. Just remember that before they said Jesus was born in a manger in Bethlehem, they said he was born in a cave in Ethiopia. It was at the Nicene Conference that changed that.
This amazing remote city is the home of some of the most incredible man-made creations. The 11 rock-hewn monolithic churches built by the Ethiopian king Lalibela of the Zagwe dynasty in the late 12th or early 13th century.
All right, brothers and sisters, as you can see, this is a most spectacular sight. Right here in Lalibela, this is one of the most famous churches. When we see pictures of Ethiopia, this is the one that generally stands out to the world. But it's definitely a most impressive. It's standing on its own rock. It's standing on their own living rock bed, if we can understand, relate to that. It's their own living rock bed that they actually used and carved it out. This was African ingenuity here that built these structures. When we go down, and you're standing up on the hill, as magnificent as this is, as you can see it carved out of this rock bed here, but it's even going to be more impressive as you get further down into it.
As we make our way down to the bottom, we notice how each church is superbly carved with a unique architectural style, sculpted inside and out from the bedrock of the earth. As our tour members proceed along the walkways of the church, they notice the breathtaking exterior. These incredible edifices, connected by tunnels and walkways, remain places of worship today. We travel as an African family, so our Kemet Nu brothers assist the sisters and elders as we exit the church. Ethiopian Airlines takes us on another exciting journey to Bahadur. The Kemet Nu group boards the plane for another spectacular sight. Our pilot provides us with a beautiful view of the Blue Nile. The upper reaches of the river are called Abayi and are considered holy by many in Ethiopia. They believe it's the Gihon River mentioned as flowing out of the Garden of Eden in Genesis.
Thank you. My world, it moves so fast today. The past, it seems so far away. And life squeezes so tight that I can't breathe. And every time I've tried to be what someone else thought of me, so caught up, I was unable to achieve. But deep